Hi friends, in this video we will discuss about carnitine. So first of all, let us see the structure of carnitine. Carnitine is beta hydroxy gamma trimethyl ammonium butyrate. This is the chemical structure, chemical name of carnitine. Don't get frightened by this name. I will tell you how to easily write the structure. So let us write the structure. So it is butyrate, so put a 4 carbons. Okay, it is beta hydroxy, so this is butyric acid. As it is butyrate, it is negatively charged in the physiological pH. The carbon to which functional group is attached is alpha carbon. This is your beta carbon. This is your gamma carbon. Okay, so beta hydroxy, so put a OH group here. Gamma trimethyl ammonium, so let us put a ammonium first and trimethyl. So now you solve the valencies here. So here it will be CH2, here it is CH, it is CH. So this is very simple. Beta hydroxy gamma trimethyl ammonium butyrate. So if you notice, you can see that it is a zwitter ion. One positive charge is there, one negative charge is there. So at physiological pH, carnitine will be zwitter ion, and it is a quaternary ammonium compound. You can also notice that it is a quaternary ammonium compound. Let us see how carnitine is synthesized in the body. So carnitine can be synthesized in the body from lysine and methionine. Methionine is the methyl donor in the form of S-adenosyl methionine. In the structure, you notice that there is beta hydroxy. So this hydroxylation requires vitamin C. For PG entrance purpose, you should know that it is synthesized from lysine and methionine. Vitamin C is needed for hydroxylation. Let us see the overall steps. You see here N-trimethyl lysine is there. This methyl group is donated by SAM, and hydroxylation is done by vitamin C. Rest of the pathways, it's not needed for you. Okay. Carnitine is needed for transport of long chain fatty acids inside the mitochondrial membrane. So medium chain fatty acids does not require carnitine, only long chain fatty acids require carnitine. So start from here, this is the cytosol, acyl-CoA. Acyl-CoA is a common name for fatty acid groups. Okay, acyl is. So it can be a palmitoyl-CoA. Okay, palmitoyl-CoA is a 16 carbon fatty acids. So acyl-CoA combines with carnitine to produce acyl-carnitine. Okay, now this acyl-carnitine can enter the outer mitochondrial membrane, and this enters through translocase. Again, there is an enzyme CPT2. So the first enzyme is CPT1, the second enzyme is CPT2. CPT is carnitine palmitoyl transferase. That means it transfers carnitine to palmitoyl CoA. The CPT2 does the reverse. It removes carnitine from palmitoyl CoA. So this is very clear. So this is shuttle. Shuttle means carnitine is reused. Okay, so now this point is very important. Carnitine deficiency leads to hypoglycemia. We all know that fatty acids can be produced from glucose, but fatty acids cannot be converted into glucose. Okay, only odd chain fatty acids can produce glucose. Otherwise, fatty acids cannot produce glucose. Then how come carnitine deficiency leads to hypoglycemia? For this, you should understand gluconeogenesis requires 6 ATP if it is produced from pyruvate. Okay. These ATPs are usually derived from beta oxidation. That is why any defect in beta oxidation leads to hypoglycemia. Like Jamaican vomiting sickness is due to eating of unripe aki fruit. Okay, aki fruit. This contains an unusual amino acid known as hypoglycin A. This hypoglycin A inhibit fatty acyl CoA dehydrogenase. So impaired beta oxidation of fatty acids leads to hypoglycemia. What kind of hypoglycemia? Ketotic or non-ketotic? This is also important for entrance purpose of. So hypoglycemia can be of ketotic and non-ketotic. Ketotic hypoglycemia you can see in type 1 glycogen storage disease, that is Von Gehrke disease. In alcoholism you can see ketotic hypoglycemia. Here you will see non-ketotic hypoglycemia. Why in fatty acid oxidation defect we get non-ketotic? You know that ketone bodies are produced from acetyl-CoA. This acetyl-CoA comes from oxidation of fatty acids. If fatty acids cannot be oxidized, how can you get acetyl-CoA? Then how can you get ketone bodies? That is why in fatty acid oxidation defects, you will see non-ketotic hypoglycemia.